Yes. As you know, I am a mega comrade, Officer Clement Iranomigo Edegbe. I am one of the open leader of People's Freedom Movement. Hashtag enough is enough. I am sad, disappointed, frustrated. Why? As you all know, a couple of days ago, there was a Nigerian citizen who happens to reside in India. He was brutally attacked by unknown men, even though they were on video. So we are recording it while this individual was being attacked by Indian citizen. This morning, I can call it last night, I got a call from a Kenyan, someone who happens to be one of our movement member, called me and notified me that this individual is dead. He passed away last night. However, I went ahead and conducted my investigation. Since morning, I've been running around trying to find someone in India in order to confirm the death of this innocent Nigerian. I was able to confirm it that he actually passed away yesterday or last night. I am hurt. I am sad. I am crying. I am crying for the family because they have no idea what have happened to his family. They don't know. I was told by individual, this citizen, it might have been an Edo indigene or Igbo. However, I'm still conducting an investigation to make sure that this our brother who was beaten to death voice we call everyone in Nigeria, every government of Africa, most especially in Nigeria, in Abuja, to come together and protect our Nigerian citizen, home and abroad. As you all know, we have a big problem. Governor Nogeyase Obaseki is a disgraced governor. We Edo, who knows the truth, who is fighting for our children, should be ashamed that we have a governor who pal himself with vampire, who is the leader, who is the governor of Vampire Squad, have unleashed his vampire gang division on us, Facebook vampire criminal division on us. As you all know, for the past few days now, we cannot share our video. We cannot get a viewer. They have able to penetrate to my internet. They invaded my privacy. I wanted to know that whatever they have done, they commit crime against the United States. These individuals have no idea what they have put themselves into. I have called an FBI this morning. I have called a Facebook cyber attack department. They have able to detect about 37 cyber attack in my home in United States. They were able to detect they have operative in United States here in Dallas, Texas, and in Texas and some in New York. They were able to detect some from Nigeria. This individual are now subject to investigation. They have committed crime against United States. For them to attack any United States resident or citizen or individual who reside in United States or whoever is operating United States internet access, whenever you use cyber attack and attack it, you have committed a felony. Not only a felony, it's a treason. You have attacked United States government. So my right have been violated by Governor Obaseki. Governor Obaseki, I always think he's smart. I always think he was educated. But I never knew that that man is so low. He have no idea of what crime he have just committed. Previously, he has a crime of assassination plan. Now, he have authorized an outside government agent to attack United States of America by unleashing cyber attack on me and my movement. So far, they are still inside my system. I was told by the FBI to go ahead and follow the adequate procedure, which I have done. However, I was also advised to go ahead and hire my own private cyber attack protect whatever they call the division that can be able to protect us from further attack until they are able to finish their investigation. However, I will not speak on the investigation at this moment. The investigation is ongoing as I speak. I want to let everyone know, those are freedom fighters who are fighting to stop corruption in Nigeria. I want you all to join me. No matter the propaganda they're going to use against us, that is to tell you our force is unbeatable. I want to thank my People's Freedom Movement members. Thank you so much for all the overwhelming support you have given us. Thank you so much. We have won again. As you know, we won against the Commissioner of Police in Edo State, which is still under interrogation in Abuja. We are still waiting to see if the evils, the vampires, can overpower our movement. However, we have won again. A couple of days ago, as you know, I raised an alarm against a criminal who was released, who committed so much atrocity, committed murder, committed kidnapping, committed robbery. Those that were involved in area robbery, they went away with about 11 to 12 million. I want to thank my people, my People's Freedom Movement, who were able to carry out our message. Now, Abuja have ordered for the arrest of this individual that was free. Abuja was so ashamed. They have requested Edo State Police Command to investigate whoever involved for that individual to be released, that criminal, a murder. I was told this morning by Nigerian Police Department, who are one of our members, whistleblower, that as he's speaking, there is fire in the Edo State Police Command. Everyone in Edo State Police Command is at large. No one know who. They don't trust themselves. They are scared of themselves because of our movement. I want to thank our freedom movement, who we have used, no violent movement. No one could have thought that a movement of 2 months old will be able to make a difference in Nigeria. I want every brothers and sisters, those who can be able to see this Facebook, because I know they're going to block it. Go ahead and continue to share whatever you can share, however way you can do it. What I want you all to do, immediately after I'm done, go ahead and upload it to YouTube. Immediately. Upload it immediately. They can stop Facebook, but they cannot stop YouTube. I want you to go ahead and like my page. If you do not like my page, whenever they start all this to clean up whatever system, I am going to make sure I start using my page. You will not be able to view our video. If you are not a member of People's Freedom Movement page, hashtag enough is enough, you will not be able to see my video. And very soon, we're going to upgrade to our own website that will be secured by private entity in the United States. They will not be able to penetrate in it. So as we move forward, it's going to cost a lot of money. I heard that they have their campaign that I'm going to do whatever it is. I have spent almost $3,000 since morning. I know how much I have spent. But I will continue to spend out of my own pocket. I want you all to know that Governor Obaseki have wasted my money. Governor Obaseki have wasted my family money. Kabaka have taken money out of my children. Governor Vampire Squad have taken money out of my family. I wanted to know this money they are wasting for me to be conducting one thing or the other. I wanted to know it could have helped students that I'm helping paying their school fees in Edo State. Now, it is a pity. I am crying because now Edo State Police Commissioner is in trouble. All Edo youth are now free. Guess what? Who is going to be among of them that is free? Are these so-called vampires? They should be ashamed of themselves. If People Freedom Movement can fight for your freedom, police brutality in Edo State that you are now enjoying, you will continue to enjoy the Enigi, the Edos, mother, father, brother, sister, anyone, youth are enjoying it. Now, when they arrest someone, they are afraid to ask for $150,000 thanks to People's Freedom Movement. Hashtag enough is enough. Let me tell you, we have won to win. We have a lot of fight ahead of us. I want to let you know, do not attack anybody unlawfully. But if they speak against you, you have every right to speak against them. If they use cyber attack on you, you have every right to defend yourself. Whatever they use on you, Likewise, God Almighty will return it on them. I said, God Almighty will return whatever they use on us against them. Any tactics Governor Obaseki have subject themselves to, we're going to make sure we follow a legal way to bring Governor Obaseki to justice. His days as a governor, his days as a freedom, his days as a man who authorized it, instead of him to use law enforcement agency, Nigerian police force, Governor Obaseki have subjected himself to vampire gang. They have a Facebook squad. They have a hitman on the ground. They have a terrorist side. They have all different departments. Now, those that are conducting this now are Facebook squad. Some of them are in America right here. Some of them are members of Edo Union Association in Dallas-Fort Worth. So I am letting them know, all the attack you have attacked our movement, you have succeeded of doing whatever you want to do. I want you to know now you are a plane. You are not play to FBI investigation. Those that are involved in this, I promise you one thing that I know, they will be brought to justice. United States justice can never be, they can never compromise United States justice. No amount of money they have, they will be able to stop our movement. So I am going to go to Governor Obaseki. Governor Obaseki will never stop. He will never stop attacking us because he knows that we, the freedom fighter, we, people freedom movement, are threat against his corruption. Nigerian corrupt leader will never stop attacking us because they feel that we are threat against their corrupt way. I want you all to know, we all need to come together. It doesn't matter how much it's going to cost you. Freedom costs a lot of money. As I am going to put everything I have in it, I want you to join us. Whenever those that are against us, if you go to Nigeria tomorrow, understand that the freedom you're going to have, you will sleep in your house instead of hotel. You will be walking on the street instead of hiding. We are comrade Iranomigo Edegbe, the mega comrade, the open leader of People Freedom Movement, and all our freedom fighters, all the brothers and sisters, mother, father, auntie, children, brother, who are member of our People Freedom Movement, hashtag enough is enough, have contributed by one way or the other. And they will continue to contribute no matter how much you try to discourage us. We already know what corruption is. What is corruption? You cannot sugarcoat corruption. Corruption has led to the whole world. They continue to humiliate our children all over the world. They kill our brothers and sisters day and day. Are we happy if Nigeria, now Nigeria is the first number one corrupt country in the whole world? Can you imagine that? What is wrong with our elders? What is wrong with them? Why can't they understand? Those that have family in Nigeria, pick up a phone in Lagos, call your family, educate them, call your mother, call your father, call your sister, call your brother, let them know what is going on. Let them know whoever that is against us are against God. Because God Almighty created resources. He gave us resources. He gave us wealth. We have too many mineral resources. Why would Nigeria be the most corrupt country in the whole world, not even Africa? Can you imagine? Before I forgot, I want to thank the IG. As you all know, I have criticized the Inspector General of Police. What he do good, I will say it. Whatever he did bad, I will say it. I want you to know, as you are watching, I understand you are watching. As you are watching, I want you to know we are not against good police officer. We are against corrupt police officer. We're going to join you and join President Muhammadu Buhari to champion it. War against corruption. We have no gun. We have no weapon. We have no ammunition. What we have is social media. Governor Nogayase Obaseki have used his map, his gangster, his mafias against us, home and abroad. I want you all to call Governor Obaseki into questioning, because those that are quiet now, they are happy that Governor Obaseki is using it against me, against my movement. All the brothers and sisters in the Edo State House of Assembly, Governor Obaseki have militant in social media department, who he have used to use your cell phone. They are operating from United States. They are operating from Europe. They are operating in all over the world. As you use your cell phone, they will use your cell phone to monitor your wife inside. I want you to know, as your wife naked in her own room with her cell phone, Governor Obaseki and his squad, they are watching you. They are looking at you. Do not be a fool. If you have it here, listen to me. all the Enigis, the traditional rulers. If Governor Obaseki visits you, make sure all his friends, anybody authorized, should drop their cell phone before they come into your palace. Because Governor Obaseki have used his social media squad to use your own cell phone, any cell phone that can video. Like my cell phone, anyone that can video, that can use WhatsApp. Governor Obaseki can use it to spy on you. We spy on your wife. We spy on your mother. We spy on your sister. We spy on yourself. They want to take your naked picture. They want to take your wife's naked picture. So that whenever you speak against them, they will use it to attack you and destroy you. And they will release it as unknown. I want you to know Governor Obaseki is a disgraced governor. I am calling on a Edo State tribunal. If you dare hand over that governorship to Governor Obaseki, you have a lot of legal charge that is going to come after that. That will not be done by PDP or APC. It's going to be done by Freedom Movement. We're going to fight. We're going to make sure we donate whatever amount, $1, we're going to gather it. When we gather $1 times $1 million, it will be $1 million. As Governor Obaseki is using Edo State money to finance a terrorist and attack United States government, and attack United States resident, and attack United States indigene, I want him to know he should stay in Edo State. If he ever come to United States, he should not hide. He should come out and let our people know. If you are a man enough, you cannot even control your own state. You cannot arrest a map, a gangster, a vampire, because he have committed a lot of murder for you. He have silenced a lot of people in Benin. They call it kidnapper. They call it criminal. They call it gang. They call it cultist. Cultists have nothing to do with it. They are innocent. Gang have nothing to do with it. They are innocent of this. Governor Obaseki is the one authorizing all this heat against everybody. I want to speak to the governor of Kogi State. I want you to know, I want you to learn a lesson from Governor Obaseki. You cannot continue to intimidate your people. I want to speak directly to the commissioner of police in Kogi State. I want you to call on your DPOs. Bring them, summon them to a meeting. I want you to train them properly. I am not going to start attacking you. I will not attack you until you do not listen. We attack with our social media, with our voice. That is how we do it. We are freedom fighters. We fight for every mother, father. Even we fight for our enemies. We don't care. You are our enemy, but we still fight for your right. So I want you to know we are listening. We're going to send a private investigators into Kogi State to make sure we investigate any human rights abuse that Kogi State government have committed. And those that, all those states that we have not noted, we want you to know that we are watching. Don't think because we have not called your name, we will not call on your name. The only one state and one of the best states that is free now is River State. Any state that is doing good, forget about it. Whatever other things we do, we will use the bad one, the good one, to cover the bad one. But we want you to join us and join our movement. So I want our brothers and sisters to know, Governor Obaseki is a brutal governor. He's a governor who is not afraid to use militants against his people. He's a betrayer. He's a fraudster. How can Edo State hire a fraudster who is unpredictable? We don't know if he's under the influence of narcotics or crack cocaine. We should call Governor Obaseki's leadership into question. Our brothers and sisters are dying in Libya, in China, in Malaysia, in India, in South Africa, everywhere in the world. Why Governor Obaseki become a chairman of vampire? He become a chairman of gang squad. He become a chairman of cyber attack against United States government. I have notified the appropriate agency. They are aware. I am not a computer specialist. I do not know it. They were showing me in the screen. I can see it. I can see it. When FBI were showing it, I was saying it. I don't want to go into detail. I saw where everything came from. Everything. The day they started, they have it. Thanks to Federal Bureau of Investigation. Whenever I mention FBI, people criticize me. Why you always praise America? This is the reason. America is a place whereby, no matter how rich you are, no matter how poor you are, the same food the rich man is eating, that is the same food the poor man will eat. There is no big, there is no small. One law combines everybody. There is no special law. There is no. You can see now, if I can be able to call on FBI immediately, on call a private investigation immediately, and they were able to detect what is happening. What they cannot do for me, they cannot pay for my security to secure my internet. They can provide security, my safety, that is personal. So I want everyone to know, we need help. However you can help, if really this is a fight we have started, let me tell you, if you let this go by, and if you let whatever they are doing penetrate into us, in the next 20 years, nobody will come out and speak. I want you to know that. Nobody will come out. Nobody, because I want everyone to seize on this moment. We have started making an impact in Nigeria. Let us continue to make this and make this movement grow anywhere. We should continue to make it grow so that we can survive this attack they have levied against us. Governor Nore Ase is a fraudster, a snake, a dark pattern who does not even fear anybody, even those that put him in governorship. If Governor Obaseki can betray Governor Oshomule, who else can he not betray? If Governor Obaseki can betray the Edo people, who are blind Edo eyes, some of our eyes, he do not want us to know where our money is going. He want to fight however way to make sure he stop us from knowing. For 8 years, people ask me, they called me, why are you worrying about Governor Obaseki? He only been there for a few months. No. If Governor Obaseki can be there for a few months and buy a house in Dubai, and buy a house in America, and buy a house in everywhere, Governor Obaseki should be able to provide job for our youth. That is number one. Governor Obaseki is not only in Edo State government for a few months. He's been there for 8 years plus. I want everyone to share this video. Share it on YouTube. Share it on any other social media. Facebook, you cannot share. If you share it, it might not show. But go ahead and try anyway. Governor Obaseki was in Oshomule administration for 8 years. Governor Obaseki was heading the economic team. If Governor Obaseki had been in the administration for 8 years, he do not know how to create job for 8 years. Why did Oshomule bring this animal? Why Governor Obaseki become an animal who does not even recognize his brother? Governor Obaseki used spy to spy on your own blood. How? I want to tell the Speaker of House of Assembly in Edo State, all Governor counterpart to Governor Obaseki, whenever Governor Obaseki and his entourage, including his SSS agent, I want you to tell them to drop their cell phone in their vehicles. That is the advice. I want you to tell them to drop their cell phone, Governor Obaseki's cell phone, anywhere he visits. Make sure he does not come with his cell phone. They have what they call chips. That chips can track your cell phone. It will take all whatever it is inside. I'm not a computer specialist. I'm a security man. Whenever they are able to take it, they can go home. They can be in Dubai and be operating it. If your wife is taking a shower and he has a cell phone, they will be seeing it. If your husband is even naked, they will be watching it. Before you go to bed, if you are working for Governor Obaseki, do not take your cell phone in your bedroom. I am appealing to you. Governor Obaseki have committed atrocity. Only 6 months as a governor, he authorized his squad, social media squad, to unleash on individual. It's a shame. As your wife is listening, I want her to think, if anybody will use a cell phone and be watching her while she's in the governor mansion, how will she feel? It's a question. How will you feel? Ask your husband that question. I want his children in Atlanta, his son, to ask his father, if you with your girlfriend is in your room, in your living room, someone else is using your TV, is using your own cell phone, your own computer, and be listening to what you are saying, and be watching you, how will you feel? This is how low Governor Obaseki have come. Low, very low. You know what I'm saying? This man is a disgrace. I thought he was smart. I never know he's not even smart. He's a dumb. I don't know if he even attend school at all. He behaved like a primitive man. There are people who can speak very well, but they can't write. There are those who can write, they can't speak. There are those who can speak, can write, they can't do nothing, they can't govern. Governor Obaseki have committed a big crime. Anyway, he's going to catch up with him. Let me move forward. I am now appealing to all Nigerian citizens, Edo State youth. I want you all to rise up against corruption peacefully, march peacefully, protest, go across the government mansion, government house of assembly. You can see Venezuela 2 days ago, some movement in Venezuela took it upon themselves. They marched straight to the presidential villa. Now the government, they have restored who they were supposed to change. You can see yesterday, 2 days ago in Budapest, they marched to the capital peacefully. Every demand they demanded, it was given to them. But our old Nigerian people, we are so used to corruption. We don't want to do anything. We are too lazy. If anybody is doing good, one of us will go and attack, even though you know it's good. They know it's good. They know what I'm doing is good. They know I'm not fighting for myself. They know. I can choose right now. Now I've wasted almost $14,000 now. 10,000 plus 3,000, and I'm still going. Do you know how much $30,000, you know what it can buy for me? Do you know? Okay, how much are you going to donate? Then that is more than what I have. Look at all the time. I have left one job. I only have one job now. That one job is $3,500 every month. You know what I'm saying? So I have given everything. I want you all to know, nobody is here to scam anybody. I am not a scammer. Whatever that you do it for yourself. Any penny you donate is for your own safety. In 1 year time, 2 years time, you can be able to go to Nigeria without going and stay in a hotel. You can be able to move freely without scared of Tony Kabaka. You can be able to move without scared of Vampire Squad. You can be able to move. Tony Kabaka is just a little boy that intoxicated. He's intoxicated with money, with power, blood. Why, Governor Obaseki? Why? I see some people from Esako. I want to tell you, thank you for your support. Who are from Esako, Kogi, Fuga. I want to thank you for all your support. I want you to know, our governor is unpredictable. He's a black snake, a black pattern, who does not care. And our brother, the vampire gang, the vampire militant, they don't know their brother. If they were armed robber, they will not hesitate to shoot their own brother. That is how they are. So I want you all to know, I love you. I want you to go to my Facebook page. I want you to go ahead and like it. My 5,000 friends and more than 5,000 that have sent requests that I could not accept, go and like People's Freedom Movement. Hashtag enough is enough. Make sure you write it. When you write People's Freedom Movement, you give a space. You write hashtag enough is enough together. It will bring out the page. I like it. I don't care. Let anybody come. Very soon, we're going to move to straight YouTube. We're going to be on YouTube. So I want to personally thank the IG, the Inspector General of Police. Let us continue to pray for President Muhammadu Buhari. Some of them were sending me message that whenever I talk about Buhari, they get angry. He's our president. Either we pray for him to succeed and help us, or we will be in suffer. We continue to suffer. Buhari do not cause this alone. No. If what President Buhari alone is the one that corrupt, we will be happy. But it's so unfortunate. It's not President Buhari alone. Please, I am not here for PDP. I'm not here for APC. I am an independent minded. I'm not here for UPP. As you all know, I have helped UPP. You know what I'm saying? So as we are speaking, our brothers and sisters, Curtis Ugbo is still in custody. He's in Sapley Road, the jail that is in Sapley Road. I want everyone, our movement member who are warder, who are whatever it is, I want you all to monitor it. Make sure that it's not abuse. They do not molest him. I want you all to know, the day they're going to take Curtis Ugbo to court, I want you all to go. Forget about what Curtis Ugbo have done. Curtis Ugbo will learn his lesson. He will learn not to support all these vampire gang when he come out. If Curtis Ugbo come out and went back to where he come from and started supporting these people, only God know what I've been through because of him. Our movement, what we have been through because of him. I don't think that man will betray us. That is in my own mind. So I want you all to know, I love you all. Please, whatever you have to assist, go ahead. I cannot do this alone. It is completely legal. Either you send it by GoFundMe.com or put it in the account. Completely legal. I don't care whatever it is. I need money. We need it. We have to secure our side. We have to do a lot of things. We have to register. Don't leave it for me. The load is too heavy. I cannot carry it alone. That is what I'm saying. They will continue to say whatever they want to say. I am begging. Like I told you, I know how to beg. If I become a governor, I will beg for money that we will spend. If I become a president, I will go to every country one by one and beg for money. What is wrong in begging? Instead of me to steal and become a corrupt leader, why can't I beg? I want you to make a choice. If you like me being honest to you, or you want me to be lying to you, let me know. I love you all. Thank you. God bless you. Those that are doing, I want to thank you, Frank Adesua. Sunday, I want to thank you. I want to thank you. You have done a great job. Please continue to do it. Those that have made their donation, please continue to help us. Call on everybody. A time will come, every member will be able to be donated 10 euro a month. 10 euro will not kill you. We'll continue to donate it until 2019. Because if we wait in 2019, we will not be able to do anything. We're going to sponsor a local government chairman from councilor. That is how we're going to change them. We have to come together and change them. We cannot do it on one just one governorship. No, we have to do it together. So tomorrow, I will be online the same time. However it is, go ahead and share it. So what I did not say today, I will say it. So I want to thank those, our movement brothers and sisters. Please, those that did not mention their name, I know you. Thank you so much. God bless you. Bye-bye. Have a nice day. I love you all.